Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Second Life Travels, and we are here today at Shadewyck Isle, a place that I was messaged about and was given permission to do a video on here if I choose to, and I definitely choose to, as this island looks very nice. As we have here, we have a billboard of some of the stuff here. We have a yard sale, a daycare called Jellyfish Junction here. And the whole island looks really nice. It looks very nice with all the trees and how everything's set up. They also have the outer region stuff, and it has a bit of detail even out there, which I usually don't see as well. And this is a small shop here called the Marshmallow Unicorn, I believe. And they have things like gacha and a vendor over here for some stuff as well. And definitely like unicorns, that's for sure. I'm using my new Blue Yeti mic that I got, so if the sound quality sounds different, then hopefully it's not too much different. And we'll go ahead and start on the left outer area, and then work our way over that way. As you can see, there's a bunch of stuff over that way as well, including the yard sale I was talking about. I was pretty much told that I can go anywhere on this island besides this house over here, so we're just going to go ahead and go around it and just check out the outer stuff here and leave that alone. And here you can see a bunch of, I forget the exact brand name, but they make a lot of these games where you get the table. They make, like, basically spin-offs of popular games. Like, I have one called, I think it's called Simopolis or something, which is basically Monopoly, but Second Life related. And they make these tables, and you can buy themes around them, so it makes them look different. And there's quite a few of them out here. Might even have all the games, I'm not sure. There's a lot of tables out here. Some of them forest theme. There was one that was pumpkin theme back there, which I think I have that theme myself for my Monopoly game. But, don't know what's going on at the front of this house. I don't remember that being there when I was here a couple days ago, but maybe I forgot, I don't know. Before, that place had band lines around it, but now it doesn't, it looks like, I guess. And here's some of the outer detail on the outer regions that I was talking about. I usually don't see this, so I'm not sure if this is part of something whoever sells these outer region environments are doing, like detailing it more, or if the owners here place this, but I don't see little details like that. That's really nice looking. And here you would be able to boat, I imagine. And since we're done with this corner of the island, we're going to go ahead and go back towards where we started and head off to that right way now, where the daycare is and the playground, plus the yard sale. We'll basically just go around the other way around the island, since most of the stuff on the island, from what I could tell, was over on the right side. There's a big, or somewhat of a big, mountain on the left side that takes up most of it, and that's where probably we'll go last. And this looks nice here with the tunnel of trees heading straight up to this building. Plenty of grass, too. And I do have my distance set all the way up so I can see everything on this island, so some of the processing for the loading textures will probably take a couple seconds. And this is, I believe, the daycare Jellyfish Junction. I don't usually come across daycares on my travels, as usually they're like a parcel that's just a daycare or something, and usually it's like, people have Second Life families, and that's usually something they might be interested in. But since I don't have a Second Life family or anything like that, I've seen like one daycare or two daycares the entire time I've been here. But since they have this is like a whole family region, so they have a daycare right here open for pretty much anybody, I guess. Little robot going around on the ground. They do well on detailing here, that's for sure. From the outside to the inside, they don't really waste much space. That looks like a sleeping shark on the wall there. Oh, cardboard airplane. This might be one of those chalkboards that actually work, since I see a bunch of dots on it and stuff. Maybe somebody was testing it out. There we go, now we can see the shark sleeping clearly. Here we have a kitchen of sorts. Little tables for the kids. And I see a cat on the ground and a dog standing on pizza. Yeah, it looks like there's a couple of doors off to the right here. Little robot's still going around. Yeah, an office of sorts, it looks like. We have another Shadewyck Isle map here as well. Right now we're at Jellyfish Junction. That's off to the middle right, close to the beach, and right next to the playground that's right before it. So probably go to the playground next and then go to the beach after and work our way around. We got a couple of photos here, probably from what looks like setting up the place, perhaps. Or at least that left one looks like it is. Nice view of the outside. Bing. No timeout by royal decree. Oh yeah, there's this door right here. Looks to be just a standard bathroom. I think that about does it for the daycare here, so we'll go ahead and head on to the playground. And this playground over here makes me think they must be big fans of the arcade, or at least gachas, because I see a lot of, I forget, it may have been Mad P over there that, at least that, or maybe it wasn't Mad P, I don't know, but there was a gacha set at the arcade, which was basically those, some of that playground equipment. I just can't remember who it was that actually put it out. I'm thinking it's Mad P, but I don't know. I'm kind of trying to think of what it is. Yeah, it looks like they have, looks to be a gacha yard sale, probably. Selling off duplicates like I do at times. Got a fairly large tree right here. Nice view of the lighthouse off on the outer region stuff. At least I'm pretty sure it is on the outer region stuff. I see an air balloon over that way. I don't know if it actually floats or not. I may come and take a look at that as one of the last things, because if it hovers around for a bit, that might be good for a last view sort of thing. Some of this equipment, that submarine I'm pretty sure was part of the set. I'm trying to remember. Can't remember for some reason. Oh well. But yeah, they do make very nice playground equipment. It's all, you got some things like the. I forget what these are called. I'm just blanking right now on what these are actually called. You got a sandbox here. And you've got a whale and what looks to be maybe another. Or wait, you got a whale and a dolphin. And, this looks to be the same thing, but like rocket ships or something. This looks really nice. We got a boat slowly going by. Don't know how far it goes, but maybe it circles around the whole island. Could possibly, since it's surrounded by water. I think we'll be making our way over towards the beach now, which is this area over here. It looks like there's a bunch of stuff out here, just as well. There's also a small port here, probably for boats and whatnot. Let's see what this says. No swimming. That says totally okay underneath it. With the tentacle holding a crayon marker, or crayon chalk piece. Nice waves out here, too. It looks like these would res out maybe these things as like floatables or boats or whatever. Got plenty of beach toys out here as well. These would be the things that you would, you'd stand a bit away and toss rings onto them. Actually, it looks really nice for a beach setup. Oh, there's a treasure chest in the back as well. This parrot must be guarding the treasure. Probably doesn't want me to take any. The waves even wash up onto the sand as well, which is a really nice touch. A lot of places will have the waves just be right out in the water, but they won't actually go up to the land. Well, it looks like this windmill broke. That's unfortunate. And we're moving on from the beach now towards, I guess, this building over here. I'm not sure what this one is. Ah, now I remember what it is. We're heading up to the ice cream parlor. Let's see what the flavors are today. Cotton candy ice cream, Never heard of that one. Marco, what can we talk about? Seaweed strawberry. Well, thanks for the heads up about the water. I did see a suspicious tentacle holding a chalk piece, but other than that, it seemed okay. Don't think you can actually get up here, maybe? Not sure. What? No? Yes? It's just for a, it's one of those meters up there. Lag meter basically and tells you when it restarts. Another nice view of the shoreline, though it is a bit misty over here. Arf arf. We've got more arf arfs over here. Whoops. There we go. Oh, there is a lot of mist over here. Didn't actually notice it before, I just saw like a little bit of it. Guess this ship did not do very well down here. We have what looks like a freighter over here. And we have a small horse stable with two horses, it looks like. Horse rides. I see one has a name, but the other one doesn't. And there's a cat hiding down here. Perhaps it doesn't like the horses. Or at least watching them, who knows. And a goat. And it looks like something hit this tree pretty hard. Looks like it uprooted it halfway. Huh. It's actually a little detail I don't usually see. And we're getting pretty far around the house now. Or not the house, with the region. We'll be back towards where we were with the games and whatnot pretty soon. And I guess this would be where you would have a picnic along the shoreline. Pump station. Now, what is doing this down here? Let's see. Oh. Okay. And plenty of flowers and whatnot along here. Like I said, it looked fairly detailed. Like a lot of stuff placed just to make look more unique. And a couple buildings over here on the sides. As I was saying before, it says pump station on that one. Yeah, like I was saying, a lot of places won't actually put anything on the sides of when they do, like, a hill or something. So it's really nice to see that. And we're back at the house from before, and now we're going to go ahead and take this trail right up here, which is why I skipped on going clockwise. And this will take us right up the mountain, I believe. And plenty of flowers and trees along the way as well. And a little observatory on the trail path here. We could sit down and take a look at the mountain and river and the buildings over there. I'm hitting a bit of an FPS drop as I'm going up here, but that usually happens when you get towards the center of a region. What's this right here? Let's take a look. Ah, they're thorny bushes. Probably don't want to mess with those. And it looks like we've reached the top. It looks like there's a small water well around the back of the house here. And plenty more trees and whatnot. There's a little glass house over that way that has some plants and whatnot in it as well. Okay, now we can see everything over here. This is the greenhouse, and it has a lot of gardening tools and whatnot in it. And these really nice blue flowers here as well. I'm not sure if this pink house, we'll probably just look at it from the outside and leave it alone, I guess. Oh no, so he actually lives here or not. And little lawn ornament gnomes around as well. And a well pump as well. Or a ground pump. Huh. Looks like they even have a basement as well. We'll take a look at that in a little bit, I guess. But first, let's go ahead and check out the house itself. This is, I believe, the house on the hill. And so, probably the main house, and I was told I could go in here, so... Very nice, and have a lot of little Star Wars cat figurines here as well. I've got my own cabinet of stuff as well at my own home. Some light reading, I suppose. There's a little puppy running around the house as well. And you got a little standard kitchen here. A lot better at rooms than me, that's for sure. Lost Junction. That sounds familiar to me, but I don't know where to place it. You got the bathroom here. Nice bubble lights. Our aim is to keep this bathroom clean. What? Right, I'm not sure what happened there, but it seems like something... for my client freaked out for a moment there. It's cleared up now, though. It looks like these are photos of the whole family right here. Second Life on the computer in Second Life. Very nice touch. And plenty of photographs in this room above the bed. And we'll go ahead and make our way upstairs and see what's up here. And I see a phrase on the wall here. Let's see. Ohana means family. Family means nobody gets left behind or forgotten. From, I believe that's from the movie Lilo and Stitch, actually. Mommy, why is there a server in the house? Yeah, this looks like this would be a kid's room. I'm not quite sure what those things are. And I think that just about does it for the house. Let's go ahead and take a look at the the area real quick, and after that we'll go ahead and take a look at that hot air balloon, see if it actually will take us on a ride or not. Oh, this actually looks pretty deep, so it was built right into the ground side. Yeah, this looks like another room actually. Ah, laundry room. Plenty of dolls and figurines in here. We'll go ahead and move on. I think that will just about do it for us here at Shadewyck Isle. It's a very nice island, I have to say. I wasn't sure what I was expecting when I came here for the first time a couple days ago, but I was very nicely surprised. And the owner that contacted me, great job. I have to say, it's a very good job. Well, it doesn't look like it'll actually take us anywhere, so it's just a prop, I guess. That's okay. But definitely, I enjoyed taking a look around this place, and I hope the people that watch this do too. And I'll just leave us off with a look at the scenery here. And this was Second Life Travels, and I hope I'll see you around for the next one.